Ever since his mysterious disappearance. You miss him, don't you?
Miss him? I never felt so relieved as the when they told me he'd vanished. It was like a miracle. Not to mention all the money I'll save on Epsom salts and ace bandages.
So then what's the matter?
I feel guilty, I guess. I mean, if he met with foul play or some terrible accident of some kind, partially my fault, you see, because secretly, I wished it.
Audrey, you don't have to worry anymore about that creep. There are a lot of guys who give anything to go out with you. Nice guys.
Oh, I don't deserve a nice guy, Seymour.
That's not true.
You don't know the half of it. I've led a terrible life.
Audrey, don't.
I deserved a creep like Orton Scavello, DDS. buying cheap and tasteless outfits. Not nice ones like this. Low, nasty apparel.
Audrey, that's all behind you now. You're a very nice girl, and I always knew you were. Deep down, behind the bruises and the handcuffs, I saw a girl I respected. I still do.
Lift up your head, wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex, wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup, don't have to pretend.
Go home like she asked, Audrey. I'll catch up with you later. I'll call for you if that's okay.
Well, of course it is, Seymour. Good night, Miss Mushnik.
Good night, Audrey. Little red dots all over the floor.
You're acting pretty strange, Ma.
I had a pretty strange afternoon. a Mushnick Skid Row florist bag in his office.
What's that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I asked myself, Carl, one night to Mushnick. But then I began to notice certain things around here. Little red dots all over the linoleum.
I spilled some Hawaiian punch and it stained.
It's hard to keep things clean around here, especially when they only remove your garbage once a month.
What does that have to do with it? Where are you going?
If you want something removed in a hurry, it's best not to dispose of it on Skid Row.
What are you talking about?
This! A dentist uniform!
Got no place to hide.
But then I catch you kissing the dentist's girlfriend.
Got nowhere to run.
And it begins to look like a motive.
She knows your love for crime.
Once he's gone, you move in, right?
I think it's over.
I'm innocent! I'm innocent.
Then how do you explain this?
A picture of a baseball cap.
It's your baseball cap. The police found it in Scrivello's office. Showed it to me and asked if I could identify it.
Did you?
No. They don't suspect you at all. But they don't know about the dots, or the uniform, or the girl.
I didn't do it!
Then come with me to the police station and tell them that!
Got a bag, Colter.
Just so my conscience will rest easy.
You know she's on your train.
If you don't, I'll have to tell her myself.
She's gonna turn you in.
So?
They're gonna put you in jail.
Okay.
She's USDA pro. Or my son.
Uncle Marco, we'll head over.
Come on, think about all those offers. Come on, come on,
your future with ours.
Time to squeamish. Come on, come on. I swear on all my stars. When she's gone, the world will be yours.
Okay, Seymour. Let's go.
Oh, wait. Don't you want to collect the day's receipts so we can deposit them in the morning?
You put them in the safe, didn't you?
No.
Why not? It's thousands of dollars. Where is it?
In the plane.
trying to reach you, baby. Have your phones been busy? Did you get our telegrams?
I don't think so.
Well, then it's a good thing I came down here in person then. Pleased to meet you. Skip Snip, William Morris Agency. Here's the table we sent you. It's nice to meet me. The pleasure is yours. Now let my firm represent you. We want to book you on lecturing tours. College Campus Rotary Club. The kind of bookings my office can do. Show the plan, then talk, answer questions. It's educational lucrative too.
My future's starting, I've got to let it. Stick with that plan, and gee, my bank account will thrive. What am I saying? No way, forget it. It's much too dangerous to keep that plan alive. I take these offers, that means more killing. Who knew success would come with messy, nasty strings? I sign these contracts, that means I'm willing to keep on doing bloody, awful, evil things. No!
I can't take it anymore! Stop squalling, will you?
she left you. You said she was visiting her sister in...
Czechoslovakia. Right. Audrey, I don't think she'll be back for a very long time. Audrey, could I ask you something?
Oh, anything.
Let's just say that for a minute. There never was an Audrey 2. And I was just a nobody again. Would you still like me?
I still love you, Seymour.
Then it's settled.
Then what's settled?
A gun!
And bullets. And rat poison. And a machete. Tomorrow, when Life magazine takes our picture, you know who is gonna bite the dust.
Seymour!
They'll take our picture, we'll be famous, and then we'll move far, far away from Skid Row. No more night feedings, no more squalling for blood.
Night feedings? Blood, Seymour, what are you talking about?
They'll take our picture and we'll move far away to that nice little development you always dreamed of. Nice little house, nice little car, and no plants. No plants at all.
Seymour, you're talking so peculiar. You're scaring me.
There's nothing to be afraid of. Just go home, Audrey. I'll take care of everything. Under no circumstances.
Feed me!
I will not, so stop asking.
Feed me!
Fine. How about I run down to the corner store and get you some rare roast beef? Maybe that'll hold you until Life magazine comes tomorrow.
No way!
It's my last offer. Yes or no?
It's better than... No.
Fine. Done. Great. And don't think you're getting dessert.
Here we go!
And now it's up.
you all right?
Yes. Oh, no.
Audrey, don't die. Please don't die.
You know, the man just said the strangest thing now. He said that I wish they could order were already inside.
It's true. I fed them to it.
And that's what made it so big and strong and you so famous.
I've done terrible things, Audrey. But not to you. Never to you.
There he is, Mr. Martin. He's right in there.
Thank you, sweetheart. Wait for me. Crowbar? Seymour Crowbar?
Leave me alone.
Patrick Martin, licensing and marketing division, World Botanical Enterprise. Boy, am I gonna gilt-edge proposition for you!
Not interested.
Let me explain in more detail. We take small cuttings, develop little Audrey tubes, and sell them to florists across the nation. Pretty soon, every household in America will have one. If you don't mind, we'll start taking the cuttings right now. I've got a truck waiting outside in some pots. Right, marketing, this could be bigger than Hulu's.
Bigger loops.
Much bigger.
Every household in America, thousands of you, feeding. That's what you had in mind all along, isn't it?
Well, no.
We're not talking about one hungry plant here. We're talking about world conquest.
Give up, friend.
cutting? It's very simple. You take cuttings from some of the smaller leaves and replant them in these pots. The truck's waiting outside.